Jaws was scary, but also a little overrated. After all, the movie was only about an aggressive shark. Just one simple shark. Well, how about a gigantic fish that looks like a minnow, but is almost 30 feet long and can shear almost any living creature in two? Or an archaic piranha that makes modern piranhas resemble trout fry? Well, just take the plunge with us today and you'll discover some of the worst prehistoric predatory fish that you could possibly meet. Also, there are some Latin pronunciations in this one. I'm not an expert on pronouncing Latin. It's just, it is what it is. Number 10. Rhizodus hiberti. Extinct, approximately orca-sized, and equipped with massive, flesh-shearing teeth, Rhizodus hiberti were enormous ancient rhizodonts, giant, lobed, finned ancient fish that could defy imagination with their sheer ferocity, making most sharks look rather tame by comparison. The huge freshwater dwellers that approached 30 feet were generalist predators and the largest freshwater fish ever known. While many modern-day giant fish are gentle giants such as basking sharks and manta rays, these giant rhizodonts were both massive and very violent in their behavioral adaptations. An ambush foraging strategy combined with incredibly robust musculature allowed lunging attacks to take down large prey. These rhizodonts counted large fish and huge prehistoric amphibians among their prey and would have had no trouble making short work of humans had a hypothetical encounter come to pass. Fossils of this terrible creature have been found in Europe and North America, preserved as their historic lake and river habitats gave way to sedimentary deposits. The dentition of the species was most impressive, consisting of highly robust as well as sharp and numerous flesh-shearing teeth. Each tooth was firmly anchored into the jawbone compared to the loose dental system that sharks have. Number 9. Mega Piranha. Piranhas are not huge, just toothy, but combining the ferocity and bite force of a piranha with the size of a small shark has defined horror movies for years. But prehistoric times offer a reality that makes present-day piranhas look like guppies in comparison. Mega Piranha reached more than 3 feet in length. Interestingly, both modern piranhas, including the black piranha and red-bellied piranha, as well as the imposing mega piranha, are close relatives of famed tiny living jewels found in home aquariums, namely neon tetras and cardinal tetras. Mega piranhas might have been huge, but unfortunately they vanished from the Earth while leaving just enough of a trace for a rough approximation of their natural history to be gleaned from the paleontological logbook of nature. Front upper jaw remains indicate the creature was likely a carnivore, but also may have eaten other things, possibly more so than modern piranhas, which are known for omnivorous dietary characteristics. Lengths of over 3 feet are estimated based on the dimensions of the remains, which were first described in a discovery out of Argentina in 1900. Number 8. Leedsichthyus. Imagine opening a can of sardines, except this time you're back in the Jurassic era and the can of sardines is about 50 feet in length. As you open the can, it contains a single herring-like fish that is about 50 feet long itself. This is Leedsichthyus problematicus, a bizarre fish that holds the record among all aquatic creatures, being known as the king of all bony fish. The largest bony fish ever to evolve in the course of natural history, the huge Leedsichthyus sea beast looks deceptively normal, just like some sort of humongous herring. This is, of course, apart from the fact that it's larger than many whales. Fossils of the giant have turned up in England, Germany, France, and South America. A filter feeder, the giant was gentle other than its startling appearance. It was equipped with a gaping mouth and disproportionately long body. Measurements were once thought to be about 90 feet, but further investigation showed that the species, while still gigantic, did top out at 55 feet in length. The gill rakers from this species are so large that they have been mistaken as being the larger bones of many other species, even flying reptiles. Number 7. Xenocanthus. So evolutionary history is certainly full of oddness, but we're not talking about rainbows and unicorns. Or maybe we are. Enter the creature that you could probably call the unicorn shark. Xenocanthus represented a prehistoric shark genus that uncannily resembled a hybrid between a unicorn and a shark. Exceptionally primitive, the peculiar creatures existed in the late portions of the Devonian time, holding out against extinction until the windup of the Triassic. This was more than 200 million years ago. Species such as Xenocanthus dahini were indeed bizarre, but not overly rare niche creatures by any means. Occurring in freshwater, the sharks have left their bones lying around the globe with 21 different species represented. The sharks grew to about 3 feet in length, but went far beyond modern sharks in their eerie anatomy. A unicorn-like spine projected from the top of the head, and it's speculated by some researchers to have borne a potent venom. The teeth of this unicorn shark were even able to crush fish with armor. Number 6. Enchodus petrosus. From the late Cretaceous and the Eocene, looked like a herring or a sardine from the supermarket, but it was a monstrous 4.9 feet in length. This nearly 5-foot-long predatory creature sported an unsettling assortment of extremely sharp teeth that could measure well over 2 inches in length. Few small to medium-sized fish would have been immune to attacks from this creature. Occurring all around the globe, these fish are related to salmon, in fact, more closely than the herring they are colloquially named after. To the amateur paleontologist, from a finding of fossil remains, which are extremely numerous as far as fossil remains go, first impressions could stir hopes of having found the teeth of a deadly carnivorous mammal rather than a fish. A hypothetical encounter with a human swimmer could have proved devastating given the biting power of this fish as well as its speed and agility. The jaws angled downwards, which suggested attacks from below, were common from a morphological analysis standpoint. Number 5. Chinlea. Resembling grotesque versions of a koi fish or a very chubby salmon to a certain degree, the prehistoric yet rediscovered living fossil species West Indian Ocean coelacanth and the Indonesian coelacanth are classic examples of how supposedly extinct species can be discovered living. Another coelacanth type, known only from fossils, makes the two living coelacanth species look rather tame by comparison. Growing to 5 feet in length, Chinlea genus members were not only sizable but had a shark-shaped head with a tapered snout that contained large, powerful, shearing teeth, which were incredibly sharp. The ancient fish were alive in the Triassic periods and have been found as fossilized remains in Arizona and Texas. A lobed finned fish, Coelacanth genera, and species such as Chinlea genus members are actually more closely related to primitive lungfish and the Tetrapoda, a superclass that includes creatures like frogs, birds, and indeed humans. Chinlea are noteworthy for the robustness of their scales and the tapered build that included streamlining all the way to the tail. Few prey targeted would be able to escape a swift attack from its biting grip. Further, the weight of this fish reached around 150 pounds. Number 4. Eusthenopteron. Sometimes nature creates a type of animal that recalls a weapon more than a typical animal. Fish evolution back in the Devonian epoch at 370 million years ago produced extraordinary results in the form of the Eusthenopteron genus of predatory lobe-finned fish. In Greek, the genus name means to have strongly developed fins, which it certainly achieved. Members of this genus were aggressive carnivores that looked startlingly similar to the military hardware familiar today as either airborne cruise missiles or underwater weaponry, such as the torpedo. Miguasha National Park in the eastern Canadian province of Quebec contains numerous fossil remains. Long-bodied, the fish reach between 5 and 6 feet in length. The broadly shaped skull housed numerous sharp teeth. Furthermore, the jaws were lengthy, with toothy rows extending far back into the head. The presence of numerous median fins located to the rear of the body, just ahead of the tail fin, is the most startlingly aggressive element in the fish's body plan. These fins are responsible for the militaristic look of the creature, as well as giving genus members a huge leg up, or rather, a fin up, I suppose we should say, in fast acceleration in pursuit of prey. The creature succeeded in combining streamlining with exceptionally efficient musculature to become fearsome hunters in their time. Number 3. Hyneria. A terrifying lobe-finned predator type, Hyneria represented a genus of hunting fish that could reach more than 12 feet in length. At such great sizes, ferocious attacks were aided by correspondingly massive dental development. 2-inch long teeth occurred in the larger specimens. Robust scales and incredible levels of musculature allowed Hyneria attacks to bridge the gap between the marine and the terrestrial, putting shoreline prey within the reach of the hungry Hyneria. The fish were first discovered in Pennsylvania near the town of Hyner, for which they are named. Hyneria were freshwater fish with the ability to hunt in even lower quality water, which would have limited visibility. Had Hyneria existed alongside humans, the danger would have been immense. A variety of ancient amphibians, as well as other fish, featured prominently in the diet of Hyneria species, which could lunge from the water to capture prey that had mistakenly relaxed just after leaving the water or were detected loitering at the water's edge. Number 2. Ophidian Ozymandias. Prehistoric fish come in a variety of forms, and one of the more interesting ones is an ancient and obsolete giant lingcod. Neither a cod nor a ling, but named for their resemblance to the two species, lingcod are voracious predators armed with a powerful musculature, a shield-like face, and sharp, prey-grasping teeth. Once caught, their tremendous swallowing capacity ensures no escape and the completion
of a good meal.
The archaic giant lingcod species, Ophiodon ozymandias, was discovered as fossil remains in Southern California, with origins dating back to the latter portions of the Miocene epoch. The fish were able to reach 6 feet in length, hiding from larger predators and concealing themselves from potential prey with camouflage, stealth, and a bottom-dwelling lifestyle. The fish was genetically a member of the greenling family of bony fish. Evolutionary history shows a pattern of many larger species, such as this one, dying out, leaving only smaller relatives in modern times. Number 1. Piranhamesodon pinnatomus. Limestone deposits of southern Germany have revealed a startling secret from the ancient evolutionary history of bony fish, close to where the primordial bird Archaeopteryx was first found. The remains of a small but truly terrifying little fish, which has been named in honor of piranhas and to recognize its behavior, namely as a fin cutter, Piranhamesodon pinnatomus, was discovered as a small fossil equipped with exceptionally sharp flesh-slicing teeth and the dollar-like body plan of a piranha. Nearby were the remains of the prehistoric fish's victims, showing strange flesh wounds and shearing bites. It appears that the fish was a sort of parasite that often did not kill prey outright, but simply bit off pieces of fins and flesh. The creature dates back to approximately 152 million years ago in the Jurassic era, but was just discovered recently, so recently in fact that the findings were first published in Current Biology in October of 2018. The flesh-eating behavior of this fish is highlighted as an example of convergent evolution with piranhas, but vastly predating their arrival in the evolutionary timeline. Germany's Dürer Museum now hosts an exhibit to the small but vicious little fish. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do hit that thumbs up button below, and don't forget to subscribe. Brand new videos just like this every day of the week. For more from me, why not check out my other channel called Today I Found Out? I'm going to link to that below. And as always, thank you for watching.